How did you come up with the name Saaphyri?
Oh, that was my daddy's doing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. You know, he was from the South, and you know how Southerners, they think everything, you know, if it's a little blue, you know, if it's dark, you know, they're going to call it blue black. So, you know, Saaphyri, he's like, fire. And you're like, nah, Saaphyri. He's like, you got that little fire, too.
So amazing.
Like, I do, daddy. Yeah, he's like, yeah. So, you know, that's what it was, and it stuck with me.
Nice. Mm-hmm. So did you grow up close to him, your father or your mother?
Oh, very, very close. I was a daddy's girl.
Really?
Oh, definitely a daddy's girl. Yeah, we were extremely close, extremely.
And is he aware that you was on a TV show with Flavor of Love?
Well, he might be aware of it, but he probably aware of it from heaven, because he was already deceased.
Oh, he was already dead. He did.
Yeah, but I have a feeling he do know, because, like, in my dreams and stuff, sometimes, you know, you talk to your, you know, people that have gone on, and he told me, he said, you're a wild one for that. So he laughed, and we laughed about it, so, yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, so I don't know, if, you know, like I said, it was a dream, so I ain't gonna say it was real, but, yeah we kiki'd.
Amazing. Nice. And so you are, I know, so your mother, is she aware? Is she still living, or is she dead?
Yeah, she's alive, and
what does she think about all this?
My mama, she don't watch TV like that, but she had the aftermath. So, like, when everything was really popular, it's like, oh, your daughter this, your daughter that. So just, like, I think in 2018, she finally saw some of the show, like, on Hulu or something like that. So, yeah, she didn't even know. She was like, what? I didn't know all that was going on.
Whoa.
So, yeah, my mom, she didn't really see too much.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you grew up in, you were born and raised in South Central L.A., right?
Born and raised in L.A., basically in the Crenshaw District. My dad, well, my grandma's house was on 60th and Bryanhurst.
Oh, yeah.
But then my dad's house is in View Park.
Oh.
So that's the quote-unquote Black Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
yeah, sure is.
They're still South Central, though.
That's right.
You come off that hill,
so how did you end up on Flavor of Love?
I ended up on Flavor of Love because I actually was online, and I went to Craigslist. And so when I got on Craigslist, like, would you like to date a rapper? I was like, yeah, I'll date a rapper. You know what I'm saying? I was like, this probably gonna be lit. You know, so I ended up going on there, and I actually did the pilot for them to get the show.
Uh-huh.
So after I saw the first season, I was like, dang, I was like, I should be on this, you know, show. So I finagled my way back to the auditions. The casting director loved me or whatever. So he pulled in the executive producer, which was this guy by the name of Matt Hodges. Matt Hodges come hobbling down the hall because he had broke his leg. So he was like, Saaphyri, he's like, you can't be on the show because you did the pilot. He said, but I still want you to be on the show. We got something else for you. I was like, I'm down, whatever y'all want to do. And God would have it, it turned into a whole nother thing.
Why? Wow, that's amazing. And so did you become the Flavor Love guy woman, like the head of the house or something like that? Or his main woman?
Nah. Flavor had no main woman.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he had a main woman, but she wasn't on the show.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, but but they said, we want you to help pick the girls. So what we're gonna do is have you spy on the girls or whatever. So that way you could tell him who's good for him and who's not good for him.
Okay.
Right, so I was like, oh, I could do that. So the beginning of the show, we all outside waiting. He pulls up in his limo. He gives everybody flowers. He forget to give me flowers, probably because he knew I wasn't gonna be there.
Right.
But then I was like, Flav, you didn't give me no flowers. So he gave me this big ass,
big
bouquet of flowers. So once he gave me the big bouquet of flowers, I was like, yeah. So the girls was looking like, Since they only had one flower, they're like, she gonna get a whole bouquet. We don't like her. So they said, anyway, go upstairs and find your bed. So I go darting up the stairs, booty jiggling, tigglies jingling. I dart up there. I find a bed that I'm gonna sleep on. Well, I ain't gonna sleep on because I ain't really supposed to be there.
Right.
But this girl, she said, no, this is her bed. I was like, no, this is not your bed. This is my bed. And it became a problem. And then she hit me with a flower.
The white girl, right?
Yeah, she happened to
be white. I remember you, the white girl, fighting.
Yeah, the girl hit me with the flowers. And sir, you know how we are. It's like, you don't hit me with stuff. You talk to me from a distance. Do not touch me. So she hit me with flowers. And then we had a tussle. And we tussled around the bed and stuff. And, yeah, it became a thing.
You ended up with the bed?
Well, I ended up going home because I was going to go home anyway.
Oh, okay. Wow.
I wasn't even supposed to have a bed.
Yeah.
So she ended up making it into like this big thing, so, and stuff. So, you know, they broke it up and whatever. And of course, I did end up going home. But once the season aired and the ratings started coming through, Matt called me that night. He said, "We got something else for you."
Nice.
So I was like, "Look at God." You know, so yeah. Because I was like, these people ain't gonna never mess with me ever again in life.
And so you also was in a charm school with Monique.
Yes.
I had Monique on the show before.
Really?
Yeah, she was on the radio, this show, right? Oh, yeah, she was on The Father State.
Yeah, you should have asked her about me.
I didn't know at the time. I did not know. How did that go for you? How did that happen? How did it go?
Well, like I said, once the original Flavor of Love season 2 aired, they said, "We got something else for you. So we want you to come to the reunion. Don't act up. We got something else for you." I was like, "Oh, you got to tell me twice." It's all right. Yeah. Well, act up. So I went on there, did my thing. They said, "Okay, we want you to come on Charm School." So I was like, "Charm School?" I was like, "Oh, that's dope. Okay, we're going on Charm School." They didn't tell us who the host was going to be till we got there and stuff, right? So we got there and I seen it was Monique. I was like, "I love Monique. She's funny as hell." You know, so we go on there and everything, and I won because I'm charming.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. What's your impression of this Flavor of Love guy? What's your impression of him?
My impression of Flavor Flav?
Impression of him, yeah.
Well, I had met Flavor Flav before I even went on the show. I had met Flavor Flav like years before I went on the show. And my impression was always cool because we had went to a Public Enemy concert, me and my friend. We had snuck out the house, went to San Diego to a Public Enemy concert.
Yeah.
And he let us in backstage. So I always had love for him. He didn't even, you know, he didn't remember that.
Right.
But I reminded him of it. And he was like, yeah. So.
And how about Monique? What was your impression of her?
My impression of Monique is she's like I said, I always thought she was funny and stuff, right? And on the show, she was cool. She was doing what she was supposed to do, which was be a house mom or whatever, you know, a TV house mom.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's a difference, you know? So a lot of the things she might want to do is like the producers don't necessarily want her to do. So, yeah, but my impression of her was, yeah, everything was good.
So what's important to you?
In what way?
Anyway, what's important to you? When you sit back and nobody's around and Saaphyri is all along the room, what's important to you?
I would say one of the things that are most important for me is peace, especially peace of mind. So long as people don't come around disturbing my peace, we good. That's very important. And I think my relationship with God is very important to me because that's the only being that's the most important to me. Keep it 100.
And so do you have peace?
Yes.
All the time?
No. Of course, like, who peaceful all the time? I mean, like, no, I don't got peace all the time. But
why
I have
not?
Who would? I mean, think about it. Just like, okay, perfect example. I'm riding here. I'm driving here. I'm on the freeway. I mean, excuse me, on La Cienega. I'm on La Cienega. I'm finna go all the way to the right lane because I'm finna swerve back over and cut over in front of this person that's going slow. But no, the slow person decided to speed up. So then I couldn't get in front of him. That disturbed my peace for a minute till I got behind him and said, you know what? I'm not finna let this disturb my peace. I'm finna just be peacefully slow and I will get there at the right time.
Amazing. So I gotta ask this, it just occurred to me.
Okay.
When you and this white girl were fighting, it wasn't acting, it was the real deal?
No, it was real.
It was real?
It was real. Back in when I was doing charm school and Flavor of Love and all that stuff, it wasn't scripted like it was now. They basically put us in situations. Like they would put us in a situation, like this would be a test, sitting here doing this interview with you.
Right.
It's like, you know, sit there and then see if you're gonna ask me something stupid and if I'm gonna fall for it and go, you know, and blink out. So it was like, at the same time, it was like that there. Everything was just a situation. Let's put them in situations and see what happened.
Oh, I see.
So no, it wasn't. And like I said, I felt so bad having to like tussle with her like that because I don't feel like it was a real fight. I feel like it was just like a little disagreement. You know what I'm
but
saying?
But she was like really crying. She had taken it seriously. Did you feel for her when she was crying?
Hell no, I didn't feel for her when she was crying.
You did not?
No, that was, I'm just going to keep it 100. Those were white girl tears. That was those tears. And when white girls, they be doing something, they know they out of line, and they start crying, oh, my God. No, I didn't feel for her. I feel like if she would not have hit me, nothing wouldn't have happened.
And she said to you, if I remember correctly, this is not the hood. This is... I'm a white girl. I'm not in the hood. You fight me like I'm in the hood or something like that.
Yeah, she said,
like, I'm from the valley.
She said, I'm frail. Look at me.
Yeah.
I'm frail. I'm a white girl. I was like, look at you. I saw you when you was on the ground. I've seen you. I don't need to look at you no more.
You didn't feel bad fighting with a white girl?
Why would I feel bad fighting with a white girl opposed to a black girl?
Because she wasn't from the hood.
And that's supposed to make a difference.
There was no competition.
I feel like this. Like I said, keep your hands to yourself. It won't be no problems. I don't care if you're white. I don't care if you're Asian. I don't care if you're black. I don't care if you're Honduras.
I don't care
if you're an alien with little green long limbs. And so if you come around here hitting me with flowers and hitting me with this, then we gonna tussle.
Amazing.
And then, you know, I tried to make up with her at the end, you know.
Oh, did y'all make up?
No.
Y'all didn't?
I don't. You know what? I'm gonna give you 100. This been 10 years. I wasn't really trying to make up with her. I just was just like being myself.
Oh, okay.